Hello everyone, I'm Anita with AnitaByDesign.com and welcome back to the Beginner's Sewing Course. Today we're starting project number 2 and we're going to be making a maxi skirt. The pattern we'll be using is New Look 6458. So this is the one you will be purchasing. And as far as the tools you're going to need your paper scissors, your fabric scissors, your seam ripper, just in case you make a mistake and you have to rip the seams. You're going to need your seam gauge. You're going to need a water-soluble pencil or a disappearing ink pen. You're going to need your straight pins. This pattern is sized for a stretch knit only. So we will be using ballpoint straight pins. So if you don't have those, I would suggest purchasing them. You're going to purchase a knit fabric. You're going to need your thread in a coordinating color to go along with your fabric. You can use the metal washers in place of the straight pins if you prefer. You're also going to need elastic, and you will follow the back of your envelope as far as the width, but you're going to need 1¼-inch width elastic, and I want you to get a knit elastic. And if you can't find the knit elastic in the 1¼-inch, you can get the 1½-inch knit elastic and just trim 1/4 off, and that'll give you the 1¼-inch elastic. Or you can use a sport elastic, and this one I found easily in 1¼-inch width, and they both work really well for what we're going to be doing. You're also going to need your tape measure, and for this pattern we're going to be measuring our hip to determine which size we're going to purchase and the size we're going to cut. Now today I am introducing a new tool. And this is a presser foot attachment for your machine, and it's called the walking foot. The walking foot is good for sewing through multiple layers of fabric, thick layers like if you're quilting, but it's also really great for fabrics that are prone to slipping or puckering, and that happens sometimes when you're sewing with knit fabrics. So this works wonders. Now, if you are not able to purchase this right away, it's okay. You can use your regular presser foot, and I will be using my regular presser foot so that you can see that it can be done without a walking foot. But if you're able, this is just a wonderful tool to have, and you can add it to your sewing kit later if you choose. Okay? Now, before purchasing the pattern, we're going to need to take our hip measurement, and I want you to go ahead and grab your tape measure, position yourself in front of a mirror, and we're going to take your hip measurement. We're going to take our hip measurement, but we're also going to take a length measurement so that we know what length we want our skirt. Now, make sure you put on a pair of shoes, the pair of shoes that you plan on wearing with your skirt. Whenever you're making a long skirt, take your measurement, your length measurement, wearing the pair of shoes that you plan to wear with that skirt. So, for your hip measurement, I want you to make sure that you're standing with your feet planted just under your hip, just straight. Don't stand with your legs spread apart, and don't stand with your legs close like this. You want to be at a natural standing position with your feet planted under your hip. Then what you're going to do is locate the widest area of your hip. And let me check mine. I'm right here. So this is the widest part. So I'm going to take my tape measure, and I'm going to measure around this part from the rear all the way around to get that measurement. And you want to make sure that your tape measure is parallel with the floor to get the true measurement. Okay? So you're going to write that number down, and that's the number you're going to use to purchase the size pattern that you need. Okay? Then for your length measurement, what you're going to do is take your tape measure. The smallest number, number one, is going to fall toward the floor. So you're going to have the increasing numbers up towards your waist. So wherever you like to wear the waistline for your skirt, this is where I usually wear my skirts, right here. So you're going to take your tape measure and place it from the back right at that area where you like for your skirt to fall. And then you're going to let your tape measure fall to the floor. You're going to need to look in the mirror when you do this. So you're going to turn around and let that tape measure hit wherever you want it to fall. I like for my skirts to hit just at the ground. So that's my measure. Okay? I'll turn this way so you can see. that's my measure. So I'm gonna take it wherever it hits my waistline and look at that number. And then I'm gonna take that number, you're gonna take that number, and I would add maybe an inch, because once you get your skirt on, it's gonna be a little bit fitted in this area. And if you have a larger or a rounder bum, then it's gonna, you know, curve around there, so it could rise a little bit. So go ahead and add an inch, you know, if you like, and then you'll be ready. So go ahead and take your measure, and then you can go ahead and purchase your pattern, and then meet me back at the cutting table. Before we apply the pattern pieces to your fabric and start cutting, I want to show you guys how to do a pattern adjustment, just in case you need to do it. Now for me, my hip size compared to the waist size in the patterns is not even, or I won't cut on the same line, because I have to cut a size 12 in my waist and I have to cut a size 16 in the hip area. So I'm gonna show you how to make an adjustment where you just blend from the 12 down to the 16, or whichever numbers you have to blend to. So the first thing you're gonna need to do is you're gonna need to take another measurement. You're gonna take a length measurement from your waistline, or wherever your skirt is going to fall on your body. So you take your measurement from the top of that waistband down to the fullest part of your hip. Okay, and whatever that measurement is, you're going to go ahead and write that down. So we're going to call it waist to hip, and write that measurement. Mine is 11 inches. Then you're going to measure your waistband, and I already know it because I took the measurement, but you just fold your waistband in half, and we all have the same pattern piece, and it's going to be 1.5 inches. So your waistband measurement is 1.5, so write that down. Waistband, 1.5. Now we're going to put this aside. Before we go any further, I have to introduce you guys to an additional tool. It's optional. You don't need it, but it really is handy, and it will make your job a lot easier when you're blending your lines on the hip curve. So it's called the hip curve ruler, and you can purchase it at your local fabric store or online at one of the sewing supply websites. So that's the hip curve ruler. Now, what we're going to do first is we need to determine where our hip line is on this pattern piece. Now, my waist to hip measure is 11 inches, so I need to go from 11 inches, or from the top of the waist down 11 inches, to determine where my hip measurement is. Now, I have cut my pattern pieces out on a 16, so I went around 16 on the side edges on both pieces, but at the top I went ahead and cut on a 12, because remember, my waistline is going to be cut on a 12. So what you're going to do is take your seam guide, and you're going to put it at the 5/8 inch mark, because that's our seam allowance for this pattern. Then at your cutting line, mine is a 12, you're going to measure from the slider, place it at the top of your pattern on that 12 inch line, and wherever the edge stops, that's going to be your seam allowance. That's where your seam is going to hit. So put that on the edge, make a little mark on the edge of the pattern. Okay, and from there, you're going to measure or move your slider to 1.5 inch. Because our waistband is 1.5 inches wide. So you're gonna measure from the seam allowance up to 1.5. Now we're gonna take a measurement of 11 inches. So you're gonna take your tape measure and stand it on its side so that you can curve it around the hip. And you're gonna go from where the slider is at the 1.5 inch mark, and then you're gonna measure down just the way I'm doing until you get to that measurement for your waist to hip measurement. Mine is 11, so I'm going to stop right there and make a mark right here. So this lets me know that this is where my hip curve, the widest part of my hip is. So now let's go ahead and make the adjustment on the pattern piece. So taking your hip curve ruler, now I'm going to show you how to do this without a hip curve ruler in case you don't go out and purchase one. So you're going to take the wide end, the wide curved end of the ruler, and place it at the top on your 12 line or whichever line you're cutting. So you're going to place it right there on the edge. Then you're going to hold it and you're going to slide this ruler back until it hits this mark. And right where it hits the mark, you have your new curve line. And then you're going to take your pencil or pen and just make your new line. Okay, and that's going to be your cutting line for this pattern piece. And then you're going to do the same thing to the back or to the front piece. But what you're going to do, so that you don't have to do all the measuring again, is take this piece, place it on top of the other piece, match up the notches and that line right there. You can place something on top. I don't have my pattern weights. Place something on top to hold it in place, making sure that these lines here are matched up. And then you're going to just trace that line that you see on the bottom, okay, so that you have both pieces the same. Now, if you don't have the hip curve ruler, you're going to do the same process that I showed you up to the measuring. And then what you will do is from this mark, this initial, or from the top, all the way down to this 11 inch mark or whatever your number is, you're just gonna put little dashes, put dashes, and then just connect the dashes. You just have to freehand it if you don't have a hip curve ruler, okay? So that's how you're going to adjust your pattern pieces if you need to. Not everybody will have to. And then to adjust the length on your pattern pieces, we're going to do that on top of the fabric. So I'll show you how to do that once we lay out the pattern pieces on the fabric. However, remember this book that I told you guys I recommended that you get in the beginning on, I think it was the introduction to the sewing course. There is an instruction in this booklet on page 26 that shows you how to make an adjustment on your pattern for the hip using the slide and pivot and slide method. So you can also go and check that out. I'm not going to demonstrate that here because you can go to the book and the instructions are very clear, very easy to follow. She tells you how to do it from step by step. So you can also check that out and see if that would be easier for you. Okay, so we'll go ahead and lay out our pattern pieces. Now we're ready to lay out our pattern pieces onto the fabric. You will notice on the back of your pattern envelope that there is only one option for the fabric width, and that's a 60 inch width fabric. And then when you look at the layout on your pattern instruction sheet for view D, which is the one we're sewing, there is only one option for a layout. So what they have asked us to do is we're taking the fabric, laying it out flat, and then we're folding it with the right side facing up. This is the right side of the fabric. Then you're going to take your edge and fold it over onto itself to where the right sides are facing each other. Okay? Then you're going to take piece number 7, and piece number 7 has the center fold arrows. And remember, that means you're going to place this edge of the pattern piece where the arrows are, and you're going to line them up even with the fold of your fabric. Then you're going to place your pattern weights or anchor it down using your straight pins. You're put pin it around or pattern weights over here. Then you're going to go ahead and cut out your pattern piece, all of your pattern pieces. Number 6 will go down here, and then they instruct you to cut piece number 8 twice on a single fold. I mean, not on a fold, but on a single layer of fabric. You could easily fold it over and cut it on a double layer of fabric. It's your choice, it's up to you what you want to do. So after you cut your pieces out, make sure you cut your notches on all of your pieces, and there is only one transfer mark, which is for the slit that we're gonna sew into this skirt. And it's a little circle, so you'll just go ahead and use your tracing wheel, or you can use the pin method where you put your straight pin through the fabric and just mark on the wrong side of both sides of the fabric after you cut it out, and that'll give you your marking. So that's it for laying out the pattern pieces. You go ahead, make sure that you pre-treat your fabric before you cut out your pieces. You don't want to sew and then, you know, wash your fabric later, wash your garment later, and it shrinks on you. So make sure you pre-treat, make sure you wash it, and then make sure you prepare your pattern pieces by ironing them out flat before you start. If you are adding extra length to your skirt, then I'm going to teach you how to do that really quick and easy. Now, there is a method where you could cut apart this line here, and this is a lengthen and shorten line that you will see on some pattern pieces. And what they have you to do is cut on this line, separate these two pieces the amount of extra inches that you need, tape it, or put a piece of white paper or some type of tracing paper under there, tape it together, and then you have the length that you need. That's fine, but because we have just a straight edge, I'm going to do it this way, which is quick and easy, and you'll get the same result. So what you will need is your yardstick, your seam gauge, and your disappearing ink marker. And because I don't have it handy, I'm just going to use this pen and it'll be fine. Don't tell anybody. Okay, so I need to add 4 inches to mine. So what I'm going to do is, the slider is at 4 inches. I'm going to move my pattern weight. Put one down here just to make sure my fabric or pattern doesn't shift. I'm going to take the slider and place it right at the edge of the pattern piece. Okay? Don't use a pen, you guys. Use your disappearing ink pen or your water-soluble pencils. Okay? I'm cheating. So go ahead and make a mark there, and you're going to go across your fabric and make marks, little lines. All the way to the end. And then what you're going to do is take your yardstick and line it up from the edge of the fabric right along those lines, and then you're going to make that mark all the way across. Okay, and then you're going to line it up with the edge of this pattern piece, even with that pattern piece, so that you're getting that little bit of flare that you need on the end. And then go from the pattern piece down to that line. Okay, and that's gonna be your extra length that you need. And when you cut your pattern piece out, you're gonna cut around that piece. Before you remove your pattern sheet from your back piece, I want you to make one extra snip. Here at the top, at the waistline, there is only a single notch on the back piece, and there's a single notch on the front piece. Well, when we're sewing it together, we need to know which one is the back piece. So I want you to go ahead and fold back your pattern piece, and right next to where the single notch is, just go ahead and make another notch. That way we know this is the back piece. Earlier, I told you guys about the walking foot that I wanted to introduce you to. So I want to show you how the walking foot operates. First, you have to attach it to your machine. And it's different from installing an additional presser foot, what you have to do is you have to actually remove this white part. So your machine should come with a screwdriver, a flathead screwdriver, and what you will do is use it to loosen this little screw here and take that off. And then you will take your walking foot, and this little lever here, it needs to be placed on top. Let me bring this down so you can see it. When you install the walking foot, it needs to be placed on top of that screw to the right. So let's lift it back up. And this little groove, this little silver part with the groove here, that's where you're going to screw it on. So you're going to take it. Let's lift the needle more. And you're going to place that silver part right there, making sure that that white lever I showed you is on top of that black screw. So holding that with your right hand, you're going to take your screw and screw this piece on. And it takes a little while to get that screw in the groove. So you just work with it until you get it as tight as you can get it, and then use your screwdriver to tighten it. Okay? And there we have it. And the way it works is as you're sewing, you'll see that this foot is jumping up and down, and it's helping to feed both layers of the fabric through evenly so that when you get to the end, you don't have any slippage. Now, this end already has an uneven edge, but I just want to show you guys how this works. So just watch the presser foot. You see how it's hopping up and down? So that's what it does to feed the fabric through evenly. And you get a nice
stitch.
We're
ready to construct our garment. So you're going to need your skirt front, your skirt back, and your casing piece. First, you're going to take your skirt front and back, and you're going to place them together with the right sides facing each other. So go ahead and do that. Open it out. Both pieces. And you're going to place them together at the side with the right sides facing. Go ahead and actually turn it to whichever side where you're starting from the bottom, pinning to the top. So go ahead and pin and go back up. And find your notch. Okay, you're going to pin your notch and go ahead and pin the top edge. And we're going to go down and start pinning from the bottom. And you will place as many pins as necessary to have control of the fabric when you're sewing. Now, there are two dots here on the edge. I want you to make sure that those two dots are matching when you pin. And pin right there where the dots are. And I think I'll put one more pin. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to apply a basting stitch from the bottom edge, from the hem of our skirt, up to this dot, because this is going to be a slit. It's going to be an opening. And then we're going to do a regular straight stitch from that dot all the way to the top of the skirt. So go ahead and set your machine first for a basting stitch, straight stitch, and insert your skirt. Line it up with the 5/8 inch mark. Lower your needle and presser foot. And remember, on a basting stitch, we do not back stitch. So actually, go ahead and back that up a little bit. Let me remove that. Back it up a little bit closer to the bottom edge. Making sure that as you're sewing that these edges are even, that the top layer is even with the bottom layer. And we're coming up on the dot, so we're going to go just to the dot, and then we're going to change to a regular length, 2.5. We're going to backstitch, and then we're going to stitch all the way up to the top edge of the skirt. Stitch. I want you to do the same thing on the right side of your skirt, omitting the basting stitch. So you're going to pin your fabric together on the right side of the skirt, and then you're going to do a straight stitch at a 2.5 length from the bottom edge of the skirt all the way to the top. And then we're going to go ahead and we're going to pin our casing together, the two pieces with the right sides facing, and then I'm going to show you how to sew that together. I want you to look at your casing pieces once they've been pinned together, and I want you to look at the end that has the two dots. This is the piece we're going to start with. And what we're going to do is, sewing on a 5/8 inch seam allowance, we're going to sew from the edge of the casing all the way to this dot and backstitch. Then we're going to extend our thread to this point. We're going to stitch forward, backstitch, and then stitch all the way to the end and backstitch again. So let's go ahead and do that. Insert it at the 5/8 inch, lower your needle and presser foot. Do a backstitch, then stitch all the way to this dot. Backstitch again. Then lift your needle, and we're going to extend to the next dot, lowering your needle, remove that pin. Then we're going to stitch forward a couple of stitches and then backstitch and go forward. And backstitch. Then we're going to go ahead and clip this extension thread on both sides. Those ends. And then on the other side, you're just going to do a regular stitch from the beginning to the end, backstitching on both ends. And then we'll be done with, well, that's just the beginning of sewing together the casing. Once you have sewn up the seams, the side seams on your skirt and on your casing, you're going to go ahead and choose whichever method of finishing you want to use for the side seams of your skirt and do that. And for your casing, you're going to apply a row of basting stitches to keep the seams down, because when we insert the elastic, we don't want the elastic to get caught up in the seams. So I've done it on one side, and then we'll do it together here on this side. And this little opening that we applied for your casing is to slip the elastic through. So what you're going to do is set your machine for a basting stitch and just insert your casing with the presser foot even with the edge of that seam right there. Okay, and we're going to just press it down and then just sew a basting stitch from the beginning to the end. No back stitching. Then just lift your needle, and without breaking the thread, just go ahead and whip it around to the other side. This is just to save time. If you want to, you can cut the thread and turn it, but I just do this for time's sake. Then we'll go ahead and snip our threads on both ends. On this end, you're just going to grab both that loop on both sides and snip your thread. And then once we have our casings, oh, I should have mentioned that once you sew your side seams in the casing and your skirt, you're going to need to go to the ironing board and press them flat. We can't do our base stitching until the seams are flat. So after you sew in your side seams, press them flat or sew in your side seams, finish your edges, press them flat on both sides, and then press them open. And you learned that technique in project number one. Same thing on your casing. Once you sew the seams in, you want to sew, press them flat, and then press them open on both sides. And then go ahead and do your basting stitch. Okay, next we're going to go ahead and finish our casing. So what you're going to do is you have your casing in front of you. You're going to take it and fold it. But first, let's flip it wrong side out. Then you're going to take one edge and bring it up to the other edge with the wrong sides facing. I'll do that again. You're going to take one raw edge and bring it up to the other raw edge, even with the wrong sides facing. And then you're going to pin down. I like to insert a pin on both seam allowance. And then go over to the opposite end and do the same thing, making sure your edges are even and that the wrong sides are facing each other. Then you're going to go ahead and match up your notches on both sides and just apply a pin or two. Make sure your notches are matched up. Same thing on the other side. Edges are even. And then what we're going to do is we're going to insert a basting stitch all the way around this edge, making sure that your edges are even. And you're going to go ahead and place it at the half inch line on your machine. Make sure your machine is still set for a basting stitch and go ahead and baste all the way around the casing. Being careful not to sew over those needles. No backstitching is necessary. And once you have your casing ready, we're going to attach it to the skirt, the top waist of the skirt. So take your skirt and you're going to turn it with the right side out. Okay? And then looking at the front part of the skirt, here's your side seams on each side, and then you have the front with your single notches and the back with your double notches. What you're going to do is take your casing with your side seams on the side, just like the skirt, and you're going to slip it right over the edge of the skirt. First, you're going to match up your notches and pin the casing to the skirt, to the top of the skirt. Same thing over here. Then you're going to go over and this is important because it's not going to be even. You're going to take the side seam of your casing and pin it to the side seam of your skirt. And I'm using double pins on this side seam because under here, these seam allowances are not basted down like the casing is. Now you'll notice there's a gap there and it's supposed to be that way. So now go over to the other side seam and do the same thing. You're going to pin the side seam of the casing to the side seam of the skirt. Making sure your edges are even. Then go to the back of the skirt and match up the notches. Now remember, we only put a double notch in the top of the skirt so that we can know which was the back piece. You're only going to have a single notch on the casing. It's okay. Go ahead and line it up and then pin. Now you're going to notice you have gaps in between the pins. Your skirt is larger than the casing, and it's supposed to be that way. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to take our skirt, and we're going to insert, start at a side seam. Go ahead and start at a side seam. Place your skirt on your needle plate. Set your machine for a 2.5 straight stitch. Go ahead and line it up with the 5/8 inch seam line. Lower your needle, okay, lower your presser foot, and what we're going to do as we sew is to fill in that gap, we're going to stretch the casing. We're not stretching the skirt because the skirt is larger than the casing, so we're stretching the casing only as far as it will go. If you stretch it any further, then you're stretching the waistline of the skirt, and we don't want to do that. So just stretch the casing, and then we're going to apply a zigzag stitch. So lift your needle and set your machine for a zigzag stitch at the 2.5 length. All right, then go ahead and insert your needle again, stretching your fabric. And the reason we're doing a zigzag stitch on this casing is because this is the waistline and we need that stretch to pull up over our hips for the skirt to fit. So go ahead and we're going to do a zigzag stitch from this area down to this area, and then we're going to stop and readjust. If you need to stop before then, stop, release your fabric, pull it just until the casing is straight, and sew. Stopping at that pin, remove it. Now this is the area in between the notches, and that area is flat, so we don't need to pull. So just go ahead and zigzag. And then we're going to pull. Adjusting your fabric as much as you need to. And when you come up on this seam, go ahead and move your pins and make sure that the seam allowances under are laying flat. Okay, they're lying flat. And then go ahead and continue, making sure you're stretching your casing. Again, in between the notches, it's even, so I don't need to stretch. Here, I need to stretch. And we're at a seam allowance again, so make sure that the fabric underneath is lying flat. And then we're going to meet the zigzag stitching where we started, and then we're going to back stitch. Okay, let's take a look. If you fold it up, there you have it. Now, you can see my white thread, but you will be using a coordinating color to match your fabric, so you won't see those little threads. Now, you should have sewn on a 5/8 inch seam allowance. I didn't pay attention, and I sewed on a half inch seam allowance. So what you're going to do, because we have to do a second row of stitching for security, because there's going to be a lot of wear in this area, what you will do on this next row is you will go a half inch out, which will be the half inch. Okay, so you stitched a 5/8 inch. Now the next row you're going to do is going to be on the half inch line, stitching line. So you go ahead and set that up. I'm going to go down to a quarter because I sewed on the wrong seam line. And then you're just going to do the same thing. You're going to do a row of zigzag all the way around, and then back stitch here at the beginning. So you're going to start with the back stitch and end with the back stitch. And then we'll go ahead and I'll show you how to grade your seam allowances. To grade our seam allowances, what we're going to be doing is we're going to be cutting away the seam allowance in layers to reduce the bulk in this area. So what I want you to do first is I'm looking at the front of my skirt. That's what I have facing up. So turn over to the back of your skirt, and remember we did a double notch on the skirt to know which side was the back. Well, we're about to cut that away. So if you want to know or continue to know which side is your back, go ahead and just put an X somewhere in between those two lines of stitching. Okay, and I'm using my disappearing ink pen, so it will disappear later, but for now I want to know which part or which piece is my back. If you want that to be permanent, then you can go ahead and use a mark or your pencil, your water soluble pencil, and then you don't have to erase it. Okay, so next, so let's flip it back over to the front. You're going to take your fabric scissors and going in between the layers, we have 1, 2, 3 layers. So you're going to start with just that very first layer. And what you're going to do is you're going to cut it away as close to the seam as you can get without cutting through that zigzag stitch. So we're just cutting that away close to that seam. And when you get to this part where the seam allowance is part of that seam, just go right around that seam allowance and continue cutting. There. And just really take your time on this, because you don't want to cut through those stitches, because then you would have a problem. Well, actually that second stitch is a security stitch, but still you don't want to cut through those stitches. Again, you're at the side seam where there's the extra fold. Cut right through it. Almost there. Okay, we've cut off that first layer. Now what you want to do with the second layer first let's straighten the skirt out because we have a twist. What you're going to do with the second layer is you're going to do the same thing. You're going to go around and cut, but you're going to cut, let me snip that off. You're going to cut just a little bit longer on this one. Now you're going to have more area to work with because you sewed your seam on the 5/8 inch seam line, but because I sewed mine on the 1/2 inch seam line, I don't have as much to cut away. So you're going to go just above that other line, the first line of cutting, and you're going to cut all the way around. Okay, so just go ahead and cut all the way around, and then when you finish, you're going to have 3 layers of seam allowance. And what that does is when you turn it in and you're wearing your skirt, you don't get that extra bulk and you see that little bump on the outside of your skirt. So that's what the grading the seam allowances does. So go ahead and finish grading your seam allowances. And after you do that, I want you to go to the ironing station. And I want you to move my scissors. I want you to turn your skirt wrong side out. And you're going to press the seams down toward the skirt. So press your seam. First, you're going to press it flat this way, and then you're going to press flat all the way around the perimeter of your skirt, and then meet me back here at the sewing machine. Now we have our casing attached to the skirt. We have our seam allowances graded. Now we are ready to insert the elastic. So let's put this aside. We're going to grab the elastic guide. Now, you can use this or not. Grab your elastic, and you're going to need a safety pin. I have a really large one. It works easier with a large one, so whatever you have. What you're going to do to measure for your elastic is you can take the elastic, measure it around your waist where your waistband is going to fall on your body, and then use that as your elastic. Or if you're not sure, you can just use the elastic guide and you would just measure your elastic, the length of the elastic guide, and just cut it there. I'm going to go ahead and use the elastic guide just because I know it works for my waist length. Okay, then you're going to put that aside. You're going to take your large safety pin and you're going to pin one end of the elastic. Okay? Then you're going to take your skirt at the waist and you're going to insert the elastic through, and we're going to feed it through all the way around to the other end, making sure that we don't pull the other end through. So you're just going to continue, and when you get to the other side seam allowance, we have the basting stitch, so we won't have to worry about the seam allowance getting caught in with the elastic as we try to pass it through. So just continue passing that through, pulling to feed it through. All the way to the other end. Watching that this end doesn't go all the way up in to your casing before you're ready for it. We're almost there. Now you can pull it more if you like as you go along. I'm just doing this to save time. All right, and there we are at the end. Now, what we're going to do, making sure that it's flat the way you put it in, is remove your pin, and then you're going to take the ends and you're going to overlap just a bit and use your pins to pin it down on both ends of your elastic. Then you're going to go to your machine. And you need to sew these down. So I'm going to do 2 rows of stitching. And I'm just going to do a regular 2.5 stitch. and I'm going to do a straight stitch back stitch and then just stitch all the way to the end, back stitch again, lift your needle, and again we're going to just whip it around and do the same thing on the other side. Remove it and snip the edges. Snip your threads off the edges. Oh, missed one. Okay, and then being careful that our elastic is not twisting as we're pulling it through, we're going to straighten this out. And this is the part that we need to make sure we get under without it twisting. Just pull and just be patient with it. Sometimes it goes really fast and sometimes it doesn't. So just be patient, but it is going. It's going in there. Just get that piece under there and then we're good. There we go. Okay, now it's all the way in there. Okay, now we want to make sure that it's flat, okay? So what we're going to do is when we get to a part where it isn't, we're just going to use our fingers to just make sure that band is flat in there, okay? Now, what we're going to do is we're going to first make sure everything is right, okay? And then we're going to go and we're going to do a straight stitch through here, and that's to keep the band from turning or twisting. So you go ahead and just do a straight stitch from the edge all the way to the end. I'm going to do it with red thread because I am going to wear this skirt, so I'm not going to do that right now with the white thread. So I just wanted to show you guys what to do. You're going to do that on both sides, okay? But before you can do it on this side, you need to close up this hole. So what you're going to do is you're going to grab your hand needle and a coordinating thread, and I'm going to just show you a practice with this thread. This is not the color I'm going to use, but what you're going to do is thread your needle and not the end, and you're going to take the needle and thread it through one end and then thread it through the other end and just pull it until it hits the knot, and then you're going to keep doing that all the way up to close up this hole. Okay? And when you get to the top, this will be completely sealed. And after you close it up, then go ahead and turn it on the other side and go ahead and stitch right in the ditch from this end to that end to keep that, to hold down the elastic. Okay, after you do that, I'll meet you back here and we will go ahead and finish. Oh, after you do your two side seams, attach the elastic to your casing, I want you to go ahead and use your seam ripper to remove the basting stitches. And all you're going to do is place it around your finger, the fabric, and just pass the seam ripper under every other or every two stitches or every three stitches. Okay. Once you do that on both sides, you'll go ahead and pull it up on the other side and then just pull out that thread, okay? Then meet me back here and we will go ahead and hem our skirt. Reminder on how to stitch in the ditch. You're just gonna stitch right in between the seam. So position it, back stitch, and just sew all the way to the end. And another back stitch. And And because it is sewn in the same color thread as my skirt, you don't see it. Now we are ready to hem the skirt. I am looking at the left side seam of the skirt where we will be applying or sewing our slit. Now, what I need you to do is go ahead and find that dot that we transferred from the pattern piece onto the fabric, and it's going to be wherever your back stitch is, and there it is right there. Okay, so that's where we're going to stop when we stitch this slit open. So go ahead, place your finger under there. There's your slit. You're going to go ahead and put a pin there, and this is going to be our stop. Okay, now going back down here. Now, depending on the type of finish that you did, will determine how you're going to sew this down. If you serged it, then you're going to do the same thing that I'm doing. I just pinked mine and I'm just going to sew down. If you did a zigzag stitch, same thing. You'll be able to sew this down. Now, in the pattern instructions, it gives you the option of folding over the hem allowance for the slit, and that would be to take this seam allowance and fold it in. You would have a lot more seam allowance. I've taken some away because I've used my pinking shears to cut away the seam allowance. But if you have the full seam allowance, you would be able to fold that in and then you would stitch on the edge near that fold. Okay? We're not removing that basting stitch yet. I want it to stay there. But what we're going to do, and I'm using a coordinating color. I'm using red this time because I don't want the white thread to show on the right side of my fabric. So what you're going to do is place your fabric under your seam allowance, under the needle, in the center of your seam allowance. So place it there. Not the center, I'm sorry, near the edge. So close to the edge, wherever yours is. Let me take that out. Okay, near the edge. And you're just gonna sew a seam all the way to that dot, and then we're going to square it off. So I'll show you how to do that. So go ahead and stitch, back stitch, and we're using a straight stitch. And sew all the way to the dot. Staying near the edge of the seam allowance. Just when we get to that pin, we're going to stop. Remove your pin, leave your needle in the fabric, lift your presser foot, and turn your fabric. Okay? Then you're going to lower your presser foot, and you're going to sew a couple of stitches, back stitch. That's just to secure that edge, and then go over to the other edge on the other side, back stitch. Come forward, lift your presser foot, and turn the fabric, moving all the bulk to the back of your machine, the bulk of the fabric, and then we're going to sew from this point all the way to the edge of the fabric. Stitch. Now we're gonna go, see you have your stitch there for your slit. Now we're gonna go and remove the basting stitch from this slit. So you're just gonna open out your fabric, push the seam ripper through, pull until you meet resistance and push through. This is the same technique we used in project number one. So you're gonna go ahead and do that and remove the stitches all the way to the square where we squared it off here. And then you're going to hem your skirt. Okay, we're ready to hem our skirt. Now, according to the measurement that we took, the length measurement for the skirt, for this maxi skirt in the beginning, it allowed, or the 1 1/4 inch seam allowance was allowed in that measurement that they give you on the pattern. So if you extended your skirt, that 1 1/4 inch seam allowance is still applicable. However, if you'd like, you can go ahead and try on your skirt before hemming and go ahead and fold up 1/4 inch on your edge and just pin all the way around your skirt and then try it on and see if you're happy with the length. If not, if you need it longer, you can use a shorter hem allowance. So I'm using the 1 1/4 inch allowance that the pattern calls for. So what I did is I went ahead and I did a row of straight stitching 1 1/4 inch away from the edge. And after I did that, I went ahead and trimmed my edge. So I did the 1 1/4 inch stitching before trimming the edge because I wanted to make sure I was exactly 1 1/4 inch away from the original raw edge. Then after doing that, after I finished the edge, I went ahead to the sewing machine, to the ironing station and folded over just the way I showed you guys in project number one, folded it over, making sure that stitching is showing on the inside, and that's where we are right now. So what we're going to do next is we're going to go ahead and put in 2 rows of stitching on the near the raw edge, not near this folded edge, but near the raw edge according to the instructions on the pattern, on the pattern guide. So we're going to use a zigzag stitch. So go ahead and change your stitch selector to a zigzag, and we're stitching 1/4 inch away from this edge, and that's going to be with the left side of your presser foot lined up with the raw edge. So go ahead and place that, and then we're just going to stitch all the way from this end to the other end with our zigzag stitch, remembering not to stretch the fabric. You don't need to because we're installing a zigzag stitch, which will give you some stretch. So back stitch. Now, when you're sewing along, installing your hem, if you get a bubble or puckering on this right side, what you can do to help prevent that is hold your fabric down in the front and in the back, not pulling, just holding it flat onto your needle plate and continue to sew, and that should help eliminate that bubble that comes on the side. Stitch, and let's take a look. And there you have it. It's beautiful. Okay, and it allows the stretch that you need in your knit fabric. Now we're going to do the same thing all over again, but this time snip the thread. This time we're going to sew 1/4 inch down from this first row of stitching that we put in. So you're going to position your fabric where this row of stitching is right at the edge, left edge of your presser foot. Then you will stitch from there. So go ahead and do the same thing from the beginning to the end. And after you do that, you will be all done with hemming your skirt. You will give it one final press and you will be ready to wear your maxi skirt. So go ahead and finish that and I'll meet you back at the table. We are done with our maxi skirt, and the final step is the cleanup. Go ahead and clip away any loose threads and go ahead and remove any basting stitches that are showing on the right side of your skirt. And then you're done and you're ready to rock your skirt. So I hope you have enjoyed, if you have been sewing along with this tutorial, I hope you've enjoyed it. If you haven't and you're ready to start, I hope you will have fun making your maxi skirt. And remember, I want to see your pictures. So go ahead and style your skirt, make it look really pretty, dress it up, and send me photos. You can go to my blog to find out how you can share your photos with me. And I look forward to seeing your pictures. Until next week, when we come back for our third project, remember, when you live in your design, it is from there that you shine. I'll see you guys next week. Bye-bye.